Do you want to become a data analyst by 2025? Then this is for you. 90 days, that's all it takes to go from zero to a job-ready data analyst. Sounds crazy? Let me explain. When I started playing with the data 10 years back, it took me 1.5 years to land my first data analytics job. And took me another 2.5 years to land my dream job at Flipkart. And after working there 5 years, I cracked my first remote data analytics job with a US company. If I had to start over today, I could do it in just 90 days. Why? Because back then, I wasted hundreds of hours chasing random YouTube videos, wasted much of time in the Udemy courses, and the roadmap I followed that did not work. Today, from my experience, I know exactly what is needed and importantly, what is not needed. In this video, I will give you a step-by-step pathway to become a data analyst by 2025, and it is applicable at any time. Now, one thing to remember, you need to dedicate at least 2 to 4 hours per day, even if you're working. And if you can commit, then your dream of becoming a data analyst can become reality in just next 90 days. First thing first, you need to learn the skills, right? When I started back, I started with an Excel. You can start with an Excel because it is easy to learn. It does not take much time. So let's see what you should exactly learn on Excel. It should not take much time to learn Excel. Ideally, it should take 7 to 10 days or max 15 days. What you can do, you can start with aggregated functions like sum, average, count. Then you can go to the logical function, which is if, and you know, if error, or then the next should be lookup function, where VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, and XLOOKUP. Then you can, you know, go to the text function, which is concat, left, right, and data validations. And then you have conditional formatting. You can work on that. Then definitely sorting and filtering is a important thing. And after that, you can also work on the data cleaning because this is very important in data analytics. Cleaning a data, it's one of the important factor. So remove duplicate, text to column, all these functions you should cover. And then the final one, I should say, the pivot tables. It is one of the important to, it tells you how, you aggregate the data, how you can work with the tables and all the part. And then definitely work on the charts, like all the regular normal chart, which is like column chart, which is pie chart, and all the chart. And then definitely go to the waterfall and the histogram, which is both the charts are very important. And then try to create an Excel dashboard, like just pick any data, put the data, and then apply all the skills you have, and then create something simple and meaningful dashboard. And after that, you can also learn something called Power Excel, which is like Power Query, a bit of DAX, and then get the data from very different sources and all this thing. Now, the best platform I would say to learn Excel is the W3 School. You can go and you can check that, check their Excel program, or you can pick any good YouTube videos and find this topic. Also, I have created 3 series YouTube videos, which is like use Excel like a pro. You can also check that out. I've covered almost 80% of this topic in just 1 hour. So it will take hardly 2-3 hours for you to practice the entire part. You can go and check that out and you can learn the Excel. The next one in the skills is SQL. This is one of the most important tool for any data professionals. Now, what you should learn in SQL, let me show you. You should start something with basic database concept and the DDL, DML and DCL concept. Then you should also look into create, insert, update and delete function. And then start with the basic database concept, which is like select, where, order by, group by, and having. After that, go to the aggregated function, like sum, average, mean, max, also the distinct and the count function. And then definitely work on a couple of other functions like call is, null if. Also, case statement is one of the important thing. Try on that. And then definitely this is one of the important is joins. So like inner joint, left joint, right joint, get a very good idea of joins on the SQL. And once you get a good idea on joins, you should go to the subqueries then, and then get some idea on union and union all and all the function. And this is a basic of SQL. Once you are done with, you know, a basic and intermediate SQL, then definitely go and, you know, learn about the Windows function, which is like row number, rank, dense rank, lead lag, partitions, everything. This is very, very important. And then you should go to the, you should go and apply something on your Windows function, which is like aggregated function, like, you know, total, you know, total sum or running total and all these things. This is one of the key questions you get on, you know, interviews as well. So definitely you should learn. Also, one more point over here, that you should know SQL in depth. You should have a very good knowledge on SQL. Even if you're a fresher, you should have very in-depth knowledge on SQL. That should be my recommendation always to you. Now, there are two best platform I would recommend you to learn SQL if you're starting out, which is W3 School. They have a very beautiful small snippet courses. You can go and you can learn from there, and then you can, you know, go also check out the Geeks for Geeks, the SQL courses. They have also good details on that. Go and, you know, check out some YouTube videos. You can put these functions and kind of get specific knowledge from YouTube. I have created one of the videos in YouTube on SQL basic syntaxes. You can go and check that out as well. And after that, do some data work on SQL. Like, you can download the data, put the data on your DB, anything like SQL Server, MySQL, whatever database or ID platform you are using, put that data and then try to work on that. Okay, do practice. Don't just stick to only the tutorials. That would be my recommendation on for the SQL part. And then once you get a good idea, you should come back and learn the Power BI, which is data visualization tool. Now, the question would be like, should I learn Power BI? Should I learn Tableau? Or should I learn something else? If you ask me, or my recommendation would be learn Power BI. Because if you don't know Tableau, then and if you're coming from an Excel background, then learning Power BI is more easy. Not only that, right now in the market, the Power BI has more demand than Tableau, because Tableau as a software is not, you know, in the competition is anymore. So Power BI, you can start learning Power BI. Now in Power BI, what you should learn, you can start with introduction to the, you know, Power BI interface, understand the GUI, then understand how you can import data from very different sources. Try one of the database you have worked with in the SQL. Then you can go and do the data transformation on Power Query. If you do my course on Excel, I talked about the Power Query as well, which is very similar to the Power Query in Power BI. You can do check out that as well. And then definitely try to, you know, play around all the visuals like bar chart, line chart, and, you know, do apply filters and the slicers. And then definitely the most important thing in Power BI is to create the DAX, right? Work on the DAX. Try to work on all the basic DAX, and then, you know, text function or all the other DAX function. Get idea of the time intelligence function in DAX, which is also important. And once you do that, try to work on, or try to create a simple Power BI dashboard out of your any data you are working on, or any data you have downloaded from your tutorials, right? And once you do that, try to, you know, work on Power BI service. I know you need a license, but it is just 800 rupees for 1 month. So you can try out that 800 to 880 rupees for 1 month. You can try out that. You can, you know, publish a dashboard. One of the good courses I can recommend, which is in the Udemy, you can go and check this out. This is one of the course which complete or which covers everything. You can do the course from here, or you can try from YouTube free courses as well. Through all the concept I have shared over here. Now the last one on the skill segment is a Python. Now I would say this is optional. Why? Because if you're coming from a non-tech background and you don't have much idea on technology or the programming, then you can skip that. Even it, like in the mid of my career, I started working on Python. Now it's not a mandatory, lot of job does not require a Python, but if you know a Python, then that would be a advantage for you, because your horizon of job would get increased if you have that knowledge. So in Python, I would recommend you not to waste too much of time, but just go and try to do all, you know, this exactly this in Python, right? You start with simple understanding of variable and data types, and then you understand the conditional statement and loops, basic of that, then understand the basic of functions. Also, definitely, this is very important, like list, tuples, and the dictionaries. Understand that. And then definitely try to work with the files, like how you can get the CSV and how you can get the Excel file, and then can work on that. And then you can just, you know, upload any data and just try to do data, simple data analysis using Python, or maybe whatever you have done on Excel, you can just replicate that same thing on Python. Now the next step is learning, right? Now it is the point everyone make the mistake, right? Everyone stuck into the tutorial, they don't actually practice. But for to crack any interview, you need to have a very good knowledge, practical knowledge on that. So for that, what you should do, you should once you're done with the tutorial, or once you're done with, you know, on your knowledge, you should quickly move on to the practice of that. Now for example, for Excel, you can go and do the practice from excelpracticeonline.com, which they have a good practical options for Excel. For SQL, I would recommend you definitely go and check out the HackerRun SQL questions, and definitely try to complete the lead code question, which is 50 lead code question on SQL. For Power BI, you can go and, you know, put it on Google and ask for the question answer. But here in a Power BI, they ask a lot of scenario based questions, so try to come up or be ready with that sort of a question. In Python, try to get a bit of knowledge on data analytics question on using Python's NumPy. Then you should also do a project. Now I would recommend you to combine the skills while doing the project. For example, if you are doing a project on Power BI, then combine your SQL skills, like you know, you can use the same DB and then you can analyze the data in SQL, and then you can connect that DB to the Power BI, and then you can do the project. Do a couple of projects from YouTube. This is one or two projects you can pick it up and can do it. And for unguided project, I would recommend you to, you know, go to check out the data from Kaggle or data.gov, or there are other websites from where you can check that out, and then download the data and try to try to create a project from yourself, which will recommend and solve a business problem through the data. Now once you're done with the project, I'll tell you two best way to showcase your project, like a portfolio. One, you should go to the LinkedIn, and there is an option in the LinkedIn where you can add case studies that showcase your skills. So there is an option called add project. You can add project, click on that, and it gives you all the options to add a project. So either you can do a presentation on your project, or maybe if you have a Power BI link or any data link or any, you know, Python notebook link, you can add that and you can put the details over here. But if you ask me, another way, which is like create a folder on your Google Drive and then put all the details, like, you know, PBX file, your presentation, or any details if you want, and then open that link as open to access to all, you know, using that link, you can do that. So, and then use that link on your resume, definitely, so that anyone, whoever, you know, looking at your resume can just click on that and can go and can check that out. Also, whenever you are just doing the project, just make sure that in your presentation, you put all the details, like why you are doing it, what you're trying to solve, and what is the recommendation or the output you're getting out of that, so that anyone looking into that project can have a good idea about it. Once you are done with everything, now the final point comes is to get a job, right? To get a job, you need to have very good resume. Now, if you ask me that how, from where you should do it, there are a lot of free website. I'll put it in my description that from where you can pick that resume part, but there are a lot of free website from where you can, you know, create your resume. Make sure that your resume has numbers and it does not have any grammatical mistakes. If you want me to create a full-fledged video on how to, you know, create a resume, please put it in the comment. I'll create a video on resume. But once you have the resume, do a ATS check, that what is your score on ATS, but it does not matter that much, but make sure that it should up at least to 80 to 90. Your resume should have a ATS score of 80 to 90. And then once you have the resume, start applying to the job. Now, one of the best website you can go and start with that is a Naukri, and make sure that you have 100% completion rate in the Naukri. Should not miss any of the part. And also be active on LinkedIn, because there are a lot of job openings are available in the LinkedIn. And I personally have a, you know, WhatsApp channel from where I actually, you know, share a lot of jobs. Whatever jobs I get from my networks or my surroundings, I put that job every week. I try to put that job, so you can follow that to get more updates over there. And last on the job is that do a cold emailing. Now, in the cold emailing sense, right, you should send out a message to the recruiters and the hiring manager and reach out to them on LinkedIn or on through the emails and, you know, ask for a referrals or ask for or any opportunities you get, do that. Finally, at the end, I would like to say that don't quit. Even if it takes a little bit more time than 90 days, be patient and consistent on your work. And I assure you that you will definitely land a data analytics job, maybe in 90 days or a bit more than that. If you want to check out my videos on Excel, SQL and Power BI, go check out the Excel from here, SQL from here and Power BI from here. Okay. And if you would like me to bring such content on data analytics, do follow Analytics Everywhere, do like and share with someone who is, you know, trying to get into a data analytics field. And if you'd like to have any recommendation for me for any of the topic, put it in the comment, or any questions on your career related, put it in the comment. I'll make sure to reply on that. And I wish you all the best, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.